So here is a virtual memory manager, and it is responsible for an address space that it is governing. And this is the guy that is going to worry about breaking a linear address space into regions and mapping those regions to specific memory objects. For a particular process that is living in an address space to access a particular memory object, obviously this memory object has to be brought into DRAM. And that is what a pager object is going to do, which is equivalent to the idea of what is called external pages in other systems such as MOC. A pager object is responsible for making or establishing the connection between virtual memory and physical memory. And a portion of the virtual memory, that is a region of the linear address space, has been mapped to this memory object. And it is the responsibility of this pager object to make sure that this memory object has a representation in the physical memory when the process wants to access that portion of the address space range that corresponds to this memory object. So this pager object creates what is called a cached object representation for the memory object in the DRAM. So now the portion of the address space, that is the region of the address space that this virtual memory manager mapped to this memory object 1, becomes available for the process to address in its DRAM because of the work done by this pager object in mapping this memory object into this DRAM. Similarly, a different virtual memory manager object managing a different address space can similarly map another memory object and create a cached representation for this address space to map a region of its address space to this memory object using this pager object. I mentioned that the address space manager can make any number of such mapping between regions of the linear address space and memory objects. For instance, there's another region of the linear address space that is mapped to this memory object too, and there may be a pager object that governs the paging of this object into a DRAM representation. So this is a cached object representation for this memory object, which is part of the region of the linear address space of a particular process managed by this VMM1. So in this example, this pager 1 is the pager for two distinct memory objects, memory object 1 and memory object 2, and which are cached by VMM1 on behalf of a process. So there are two pager objects, one for each one of these things. So the important point I want to get across is that there is not a single paging mechanism that needs to be used for all the memory objects. So it gives you an ability to have different regions of the linear address space of a given process by associating different pager objects with each of the regions that correspond to a particular memory object. And all these associations between regions and memory objects can be dynamically created. So for instance, this address space manager may decide to associate a region in this linear address space to this memory object. If it does that, then there is a new pager object that is going to manage the association between the region of the virtual address space that is mapped to this memory object 3, and the cached object representation is the DRAM representation of this memory object created by a pager object that is managing the relationship between this region and this particular memory object 3. Now, this is an interesting situation because you have a memory object that is shared by two different address spaces, and there are two distinct pager objects associated with managing the region of the address space in VMM1 that maps to this memory object, and the region of the address space in VMM2 that maps to the same memory object. Now, what about the coherence of the cache representation of this object that exists over here and the cache representation of this object that exists over here? Who manages that? Well, it's entirely up to the pager object that have been instantiated in order to manage the mapping between this memory object and the cached object. So if coherence is needed for the cache representation of this memory object in the DRAM of this address space and this address space, then it is the responsibility of these two pager objects to coordinate that. So it's not something that Spring System is responsible for, but it provides the basic mechanisms through which these entities can manage the regions that they are mapping in terms of the memory objects and the DRAM representation of those objects. So in other words, external pages establish the mapping between virtual memory, which is indicated by these memory objects, and physical memory, which is represented by the cached objects. So in summary, the way memory management works in the Spring system is the address space managers are responsible for managing the linear address space of a process, and they do the mapping of the linear address space of a process by carving them up into regions and associating the regions with different memory objects. And these memory objects may be swap space on the disk, or it could be files that are being mapped into specific regions of the linear address space, entirely up to the application, what they want to do with it. But these abstractions are powerful for facilitating whatever may be the intent of the user. And mapping the memory objects to the cache representation, which lives in DRAM, is the responsibility of pager objects. And you can have any number of external pages that manage this mapping. And in particular, through this example, I've shown you that you can have, for a single linear address space, multiple pager objects that are managing different regions of that same address space. And that's the flexibility and power that's available in the structure of the Spring system using the object technology.